It gives me great pleasure to be here this afternoon to join my fellow colleagues in the region in sharing ideas on the advancement of education in Africa using ICT, science, and technology. I would like to extend my heartfelt appreciation to African Brains for once again bringing together the leadership of Africa on this table to share how we can grow together in this area. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'll be sharing with you this afternoon how Malawi is faring in the area of ICT, science, and technology. But before I do that, a little introduction of our education system. Malawi has an 844 education system, where 8 years are for primary education, 4 years are for secondary education, and another 4 years is for tertiary education. Currently in Malawi, the enrollment in primary school is at 3.6 million, and at secondary level, it is at 250,000. In Malawi, we have about 5,300 primary schools and 1,000 secondary schools. Ladies and gentlemen, the Malawi government recognized the importance of science and technology in the early 1970s. This was inspired by the Malawi's participation in the Conference of Cabinet Ministers responsible for application of science and technology in development in Africa held in Dakar in 1974. At this conference, it was observed that research and development and scientific technology services are a source of momentum for development and that each country should possess its own scientific and technological base capable of generating and accelerating this momentum. Malawi has since developed a national science and technology policy and is integrating it in national development as a key priority. Colleague, ladies and gentlemen, the concept of science and technology as a tool for rapid socioeconomic development cannot be overemphasized. The application of science and technology has helped countries like China, South Korea, India, Malaysia, just to mention a few, to transform their economies. Compared to the rest of the world, Malawi, together with other sub-Saharan African countries, is lagging behind in development and application of science and technology. The science and technology system in Malawi has been characterized by a pluralistic approach in its management, instability of institutions and low integration of SDI issues in national development planning process. As a result, there is inadequate harmonization in capacity building, priority setting, resource mobilization, and utilization. This situation calls for a common and shared understanding to promote, support, regulate, coordinate and utilize science and technology innovation to address Malawi's current socioeconomic problems. To deal with this challenge, the National Commission of Science and Technology was established. The commission is charged with shaping and driving new research and development agenda for harnessing STI developments in the country. In the next 5 years, Malawi will be addressing the following strategic issues in science and technology: research and development, information and knowledge management, innovation, technology transfer and commercialization, networking, partnership and collaboration, regulatory framework, planning, monitoring and evaluation, and lastly, infrastructure and resource mobilization. I will briefly discuss some of these strategic areas. One, I will start with research and development. Under research and development, Malawi is concentrating on the following subsectors: agriculture and green belt, health, social sciences and humanities, engineering, industry and energy and design, nuclear sciences and technology, biotechnology, and climate change. Currently in this area, there is inadequate infrastructure and human resources, poor coordination, and inadequate financial resources. Two, it's information and knowledge management. The major focus is on packaging and management of the information available. Much of the information and knowledge in Malawi is not fully utilized because it is not properly packaged and managed. It is therefore difficult for decision makers and the general public to appreciate the role of STI in development endeavors. It is therefore necessary to make deliberate efforts to develop and invest in the acquisition, organization, dissemination, repackaging, and translation of STI information for socioeconomic development. Therefore, STI information becomes a strategic issue. Three, innovation, technology transfer, commercialization. The major challenge faced in Malawi is lack of a proper innovation system which can identify and support innovators, put their innovations into practice, and exploit innovation in a manner that adds value to goods and services and link innovation to the market. The vision of the government of Malawi is to turn the country from a predominantly consuming and importing nation to a producing and exporting economy, and this cannot be achieved without regard to innovation. Six, human resource development and retention. Statistics for STI human resources in Malawi reveal a low stock of STI personnel at an estimated figure of 42 researchers per million of inhabitants in 1991. With the commitment of government to establish 6 universities, it is expected that there will be high output of science graduates and a convenient working environment will be provided in the new institutions of higher learning. Planning, monitoring, and evaluation. There is no monitoring and evaluation framework in the STI system to assess the progress of various policy interventions. In order to guide the implementation of STI policy and assess contributions of various collaborating partners and performance of STI sector, planning, monitoring, and evaluation is a necessary tool. Infrastructure and resource mobilization. Amidst general concerns from the science and technology community that there is inadequate funding for the sector, Malawi government, through its pronouncements, has shown commitment to achieve the 1% of GDP as funding to research and development as recommended by UNESCO, African Union, and NEPAD. Future of science and technology in Malawi. There is a strong political will and commitment by the leadership of Her Excellency Madam Joyce Banda and her government to harness science and technology and innovation. The commitment has been shown by increasing the government gross domestic expenditure on research and experimental development. Malawi has also put in place regulatory and legal frameworks for the implementation of science and technology programs. Malawi Parliament approved the Science and Technology Act in 2003. The government approved the Science and Technology Policy in 2008. This is aligned with the Malawi Growth and Development Strategy. In conclusion, it is the wish of the government of Malawi to promote research, science, and technology. Malawi is promoting the culture of research among its learners and scholars. We are committed to make this work as we know that the benefits of investing in research, science, and technology are great. We look forward in partnering with you in our journey. I thank you for paying attention.